imagine if it's your kid coming home at night and crying over a spelling test where all they have to do is spell the word bad, but they keep spelling it like dad or something like that. I listen to third graders who don't want to go to school, who are terrified to go to school, who are terrified to speak in front of their classrooms. We need to boost their confidence. We need to show them like it's okay, you're not alone.
When a student is identified with dyslexia, it is often a parent who knows that their struggling child is not lazy, a parent who knows that the test scores do not adequately reflect their child's ability.
The child I saw in school was not the same child that I saw at home. Over time, I have gotten overwhelmed and frustrated with how to help my son. When we first realized that he was falling behind in reading, we could have helped him earlier. We could have focused on getting him the right help in reading rather than spending our time trying to find the right therapist.
It is our obligation to provide teachers the tools and education they need to do their jobs by providing information in teacher prep programs and ongoing training to achieve and maintain a teaching license.
And so that screening is important because we know that a child who's not reading at grade level by third grade is not going to read at grade level through the rest of their high school career. They're going to continue to need interventions.